What's up, guys? Welcome back to Virtual Reality. Today, we have the VR and AR weekly news again. And what's on our list? The HoloLens 2 is used at the military, Robo Recall on the Quest, Opinions, PlayStation VR 2 gets eye tracking, Nintendo Labo VR is released, Vacation Simulator, Shadowpoint and Falcon Age information, and Acer announced a new headset called Concept DOJO. So, very important, guys, this news is only until Friday early in the morning, because when you watch this video, I'm in Prague at the VR Genius to try the newest Ixtal gaming headset. This is awesome, guys. As you know, I'm one of the three testers worldwide, and we will see what they have to show us. When I'm allowed to show that, or to talk about that, I will do. If not, then of course I can't do that. However, if there is some news Friday evening, Saturday or Sunday, I will inform you under this video or in another way perhaps, and yeah, you will see that. So my name is Voodoo. You can find hardware tests, gameplays, news and events on my channel, so subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. Now let's have some fun with the VR and AR weekly news and let's go. So the HoloLens 2 gets to the US military, and yeah, there is some discussions about that. Some people say, oh no, that's not good, people are dying because of that, and others say, yeah, it's good for peace. But yeah, what do you say about that? Fact is that Microsoft gave the US military the HoloLenses too. And you see some US soldiers here with the HoloLens 2 on head. And the first thing that I thought, when they're crouching through the dirt and stuff, doesn't this thing break? Or this is only a plastics cover and stuff? Is it really possible? So perhaps this is only for tactic commanders or something like that. Look at this. And here you even see a floor plan, and you see your team members as white arrows here. So you always know where they are. No friendly fire anymore, I think. Here's even a compass. And here you can see your friends or your team members through the wall. So you always know what to do, and here's even a tactical map and stuff. So yeah, this is night vision stuff, really awesome. And this is only the HoloLens 2. So what do you think? Is that okay if the military uses the HoloLens 2 or not? Write it in the comments. So Shell uses augmented reality headset to do their job. So not at the gas station, of course, but there are some locations where they have the oil and stuff, and there are some very dangerous situations for the workers, and so they use the augmented reality headset that you can see here. It has a micro display here, like with the Google Glass, and also a camera. So at the when you are as a worker and you have the dangerous situation, and then you can ask some co-worker if you are doing this right, and you can acquire some hints of them and stuff. Then they tell you, yeah, you have to put this there and stuff. And yeah, this is really cool. So for us, it's something like augmented reality and virtual reality is for gaming, but these guys use that for the job, and they wear it and they say it's just normal for them. But this is really cool that this technology is used by so big companies. Sony has a new patent for the next generation of the PlayStation VR, and this has eye tracking. Look at this, there are eye tracking sensors, and this, so it could be possible that the next PlayStation VR will use foveated rendering. And what this does, if you look in the upper right corner perhaps, and then the Scene is only rendered in full quality at this spot where you are looking at. Everything else is rendered in lower quality, so you save a lot of performance. So perhaps with the next PlayStation VR, we will have a lot of cool games with awesome graphics. That would be awesome. Also, the distance to the lenses from the eyes is bigger, so that you can wear glasses, bigger glasses under the PlayStation VR. So this is really good. Also, but I told you already last week, it will get wireless perhaps. This sounds very good. This could be the next generation VR headset. I hope so, and I really hope that Sony is releasing that next year or at least 2021. We will see. Okay guys, I tried Robo Recall on the Oculus Quest at the PAX. So I'm still not allowed to show you the recorded gameplay, but I can tell you my opinion now. And when you start the game, you are in this office, when you remember, and there's not a huge difference even in the graphics. So everything looks fine and works. But if you start the first level and you are on the streets, you instantly notice that the graphics is much lower. Much lower. And for the guys that play the PC version, they will say, oh my god, how does that look? But the people who just buy the Quest and never played the PC version, they won't care, because the gameplay is really, really good of this game. So there's no difference. Everything is fast and you can have the weapons on your chest and throw it away and grab it from behind and kill the robots and teleport and turn around, and everything works well and is really big fun. So guys, I think we can really look forward to the Quest. There are so many developers now developing for the Quest, like Apex Constructs comes for the Quest, and also this what's that name, The Exorcist, We Are Legion. I think this horror game comes also for the Quest, and there's a lot of cool stuff, and there will be a big push into the VR world. I hope so, at least. So we will see. I had big fun with playing Robo Recall on the Oculus Quest. Boneworks, guys, most of you should know that this is known as the first next generation VR game, because the physics are hardcore realistic, because they use the Valve Index controller for that, or the aka the Knuckles. And if you see the gameplay, it's totally awesome. He grabs all the stuff and uses single fingers to track all that stuff, and it's amazing. Look at this. You should really watch the whole scene. It's like 90 minutes. I will put the link under this video, and then you will see that. It's so cool. You can use every single finger to grab stuff and to pull stuff and to push stuff and hold at some stuff, and it's nice. Yeah. So if you want to play that, you will have to wait a little bit. I think it will be released in 2019. And of course, it makes sense that you have the Valve Index controllers to play this. Or if you already pre-ordered the Pimax controllers, then you will be also able to play this, because the Pimax controllers will also get this finger tracking later. So this is the same than the Valve Index controller. So if you pre-ordered the controllers from Pimax, perhaps you don't need the Valve Index controllers. We will see, guys. And I'm really looking forward to that. The game is by Stress Level Zero. They made a lot of cool stuff, like Duck Season also. And this was also great. So, What do you think about this game? Are you looking forward to that? Write it under the video in the comments. So, finally, the Nintendo Labo VR kit is out and you can buy it. Yeah, so there's three sets. I think the basic set, then the one with the bird, and the one with the elephant, I think. I don't know, there are three different kits. Or a full kit where everything is included. And I pre-ordered the full kit, of course. And I will test it for you. So, to get used to it, I just ordered used the older version, the Robo kit. And if you want to see that, you can go to my German non-VR channel. I played a little bit around with that. If you are interested in that, you go to one of my German videos, and under the German videos is a link to my non-VR channel. And there you can find some funny stuff what I'm trying there. So, I have no idea when I will get this. I think I will get this when I'm back home from Prague. And then I will test it for you, of course. I'm really curious about that. But don't expect something big. If you already have a PlayStation VR or PC VR headset, you will not be very amused by that, because it's a cardboard only. And yeah, we will see. I think it's fun. We will see. Falcon Age was released this week. And yeah, I already made a gameplay for you on my channel. If you want to see it, just have a look at my channel. And it's not as perfect as all the other PlayStation VR games. It has pretty many bugs, to be honest. So sometimes you can't go up a stair and you have to switch to teleport, and some things glitching around or doesn't work, and sometimes the inventory just pops up whenever you click something, and it's not perfect, but the game is fun. So if you like adventures, this is cool. So if you hold your hand like this, the falcon lands on your hand and you can feed it. It's so cool. But yeah, I cannot recommend it 100%, but it's still fun. It's like $20, so this is not too much for this game. Finally, Vacation Simulator is out, and it's a lot of fun. Perhaps you've seen my gameplay already on this channel. If not, go there and watch it. It's so much fun, guys. It's a perfect game for beginners even, because everything is so easy. You just have your hands, and there's nothing complicated. Just move everything around, throw stuff around, and do some fun stuff, or just do the quest. And yeah, there are three different regions, like a mountain, forest, and beach, and also your own home that you can change, and you can change your own appearance. And it's just fun, and you don't have to fear a motion sickness, because you only have teleport. There's no smooth locomotion where you can get sick. So this is I don't miss the smooth locomotion in this game, because you teleport to a special point and there you will have your fun, and then teleport to another point and there's the next game and stuff. It's so cool. It's so fun. And there are a lot of Easter eggs hidden. For example, in your own home, in your own virtual home, there is a video game console. And everywhere in the world are these games hidden for this console, perhaps underwater or in the snow. And then you can catch it, put it in your backpack, and then play it at home. It's so cool. Guys, I can really, really recommend this game. It's not cheap. It's like, I think, $30 or what was that? But it's totally worth the money, because it's so much fun, guys. Vacation Simulator. And the next game is Shadow Point. I had a chance already to try it at CodeSync with the Oculus Quest, and it was really, really cool. I had a lot of fun playing this, and it's an adventure with puzzle elements. It's mostly about light and shadow. For example, there is a big lamp on the side, and it has light to the other side, and you hold an object, and it has to throw the exact shadow, like the form is on the wall on the other side, so that a door will open. This is really cool idea, and I love VR adventures. So this will be released for the Oculus Rift S and the Quest, and it will have cross-buy. So you only have to buy it once, and you can play it on the Quest and the Rift S or the old Rift. This is good. So Shadow Point, guys. So there's a cool list from Upload VR with already announced cross-buy games. So let's check out the list. There's Apex Construct. So you only have to buy it for Quest, and then you can play it on the Rift as well, or the other way around. There's also Dance Central, Dead and Buried, Dead and Buried 2, Face Your Fears 2, I Expect You to Die, Journey of the Gods, Orbus VR, oh yes, Robo Recall, Shadow Point, Sports Scramble, The Climb, and Ultra Wings, and there will be also a lot more later. I love this. So what I really want to know is, are you going to buy both of these headsets? And when? Yes? Why? that would be interesting. Of course, I will get them all because I have all the headsets at home and because I want to test it for you. But this would be interesting for me if you plan to buy both of them. And there's the next VR headset announced. We are so confused, I think, because of all the announced headsets. Now Acer has announced the Concept D-O-J-O. What a name. So this has the same resolution than the HP Reverb. That's 2160 by 2160. They didn't say if this is an OLED or LCD. So I think as it is the same display as in the HP Reverb, it will be LCD. And yeah, there's not the biggest difference. We can see, wait, here, the IPD slider. This is a huge difference to the HP Reverb, but that's it. Yeah, we have a audio jack here. We have a head strap like with the Star VR 1. I tried the Star VR 1, it was very comfortable. Should be one of the most comfortable headsets around. And yeah, this is how it looks. And what you can also do, you can exchange the front. There are two buttons. Let me see, here and here. And then you can push it and remove the complete cover of the headset so that you can replace it with some future stuff. I don't know what's coming up there. Perhaps some modules or for arcades to clean it. Because guys, this headset is not meant for consumers. It's for business, and that's why it will be less than $1,000. So 999 is less than 1,000. So I think it will be more expensive than the HP Reverb, which is at $600. So you have to remember it's the same display as with the HP Reverb. And the only difference is the IPD slider and perhaps a little bit more comfort. So is that worth hundreds of more dollars? I don't think so, to be honest. But if you have a very unusual IPD like 56 or like 74, then this is perhaps something you should go for. However, I will try to get this at home and then test it for you as usual. But I cannot promise. I try my best. The Acer Concept D-O-J-O headset. Okay, guys. Finally, before we talk about Ixtal, let me thank the new patrons this week. Rika, Vido and Volker, thanks for supporting me. If you also want to support me, you can do this via my Patreon page. It's under the video and you can do this from $1 per month. And I'm sharing like behind the scenes videos and also high res pictures of headsets I took at conventions and stuff. And yeah, that's interesting. And you can also support me. That would be really cool if you consider that. So perhaps if I get enough support, I can buy me something like this cool Striker VR gun, because this is too expensive for me. I would really love to have this at home. We will see. However, guys, if you watch this video, I will be in Prague at VR Genius and talking about Ixtal Gaming. Yeah, this is the next high-end headset coming from VR Genius. And I have no idea about this. I don't know anything about that. And I even don't know what I expect in Prague at the VR Genius. Perhaps they even have the first prototype. Perhaps I will even get one at home. I have no idea. And if I'm allowed to tell you this, I will. But I think we will have to sign an NDA like I did with Pimax. And then I can't tell you, of course. For these guys who don't know me, I'm also one of the three worldwide official testers of Pimax, also with Ixtal. And with Pimax, I had this NDA, so I was not allowed to tell you anything until a special date where the NDA is lifted, and this will be the same with Ixtal, I think. So perhaps I will have the chance to try for you the first prototype of the Ixtal Gaming Edition that will be a high-end headset that perhaps is even better than the Pimax and the Index together. We will see, guys. We will see if that is the future or not. I promise you, I have a little bit influence about this Ixtal gaming headset. So as you perhaps know, I have all the headsets at home. I have a lot of experience in VR hardware and games. I know what is important, and I will put this knowledge into the Ixtal project, of course, so that we can get a very good headset, hopefully. So, yeah, this is everything. This is so interesting, guys, traveling around the world and trying all this cool stuff and then report this to you. This is my life. I love this. I love this. Yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you for watching. And if you like to support me, this is where you go. And if you don't like to support me, I would also appreciate a thumbs up. And see you next time in virtual reality, guys. See ya.